It's Professor Dave. Let's discuss implicit differentiation.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Thus far, we have been applying differentiation to functions where one variable is being expressed in terms of another. In these, f of x is interchangeable with y, and some x terms will follow. But there are plenty of other functions that aren't set up exactly like this. For example, x squared plus y squared equals 9 is the equation of a circle with its center at the origin and a radius of 3. How would we take the derivative of this? In order to do it, we need to use a technique called implicit differentiation. So let's learn this now. With the example we were just discussing, we know that we could solve for y in terms of x, and then take the derivative as we already know how. But this can be difficult and time-consuming, and sometimes it's not even possible. Implicit differentiation will allow us to take the derivative of this function without having to solve for one variable in terms of another. Instead, we can just leave everything as it is and simply differentiate with respect to one specific variable. We typically differentiate with respect to x, so let's do that to this function, and then we can solve for y prime, or the derivative of y with respect to x, which is what we are looking for. So the first thing we must do, as we said, is take the derivative of both sides with respect to x. That is what this notation represents, with d over dx next to these terms. Make sure to put each side in parentheses, because we need this d in the numerator to operate on everything listed, as that is what this means. It means the derivative of all of this over dx, which means with respect to x. Once we do this, it's just a matter of rearranging things and evaluating. We know that the derivative of a sum is just the sum of derivatives, so we can change this to the derivative of x squared with respect to x, plus the derivative of y squared with respect to x. On the right, the derivative of any constant is zero, so that becomes zero. Now let's evaluate these terms. This is the part we have to really wrap our heads around. We are specifically treating y as a function operating on x, and we should therefore imagine f of x anywhere we see y. So when we take the derivative of x squared with respect to x, it's just what we are used to. 2 comes down here, the exponent becomes 1, and we get 2x. But for y squared, it's different because we are not taking the derivative with respect to y. It is still with respect to x. And again, we are thinking of y as a function that depends on x. For that reason, we have to use the chain rule. Remember that the derivative of a composite function is the derivative of the outer function times the derivative of the inner function, and we imagine this as f of x raised to the second power. So here, we will take the derivative of y squared with respect to y, thinking of this exponent as the outer function operating on y, but then also imagining y as some other expression with x's in it. So we multiply by the derivative of y with respect to x, which is dy over dx. The derivative of y squared with respect to y is easy. That's just 2y, as we would expect. Then we are left with dy over dx, which we can also just call y prime. And this is precisely what we are looking for, so let's solve for it. Subtract 2x from both sides. Divide both sides by 2y. And we are left with negative x over y. So this is y prime, or the derivative of the original function with respect to x. Here's a slightly trickier one. X cubed plus x squared y plus 4y squared equals 6. Again, we will take the derivative of everything with respect to x, and we can treat each term in the sum separately. X cubed is easy, since there's no y. We just get 3x squared, as we would expect. Now, for this second term, we have to use the product rule, since it's a product. So let's write x squared times the derivative of y, plus the derivative of x squared times y. Now we evaluate these derivatives. the derivative of y will be y prime. Remember, y is a function, and its derivative is some other function, which is what we are looking for, so we just write y prime. The derivative of x squared is 2x. So we have x squared y prime plus 2xy. And then we move on to the 4y squared term. Here we need to use the chain rule, so we take the derivative with respect to y first, ignoring what's inside y, giving us 8y. But then we multiply by the derivative of y with respect to x, giving us y prime. So that will be 8yy prime. And 6 becomes 0. Remember, we do this extra stuff with y only because we are differentiating with respect to x and not y. Now let's bring all the terms without y prime in them to the other side. We do this so that we can then factor y prime out of these two terms. We do this so that we can then divide both sides by this parenthetical term, allowing us to solve for y prime, which is the point of all this. Then let's just factor a negative x out of the numerator for good measure, and we are left with y prime equals negative x times the quantity 3x plus 2y divided by x squared plus 8y. Let's try another example of similar difficulty just to make sure we have this. How about x squared y plus xy squared equals 3x? And again, we want to differentiate with respect to x. On the left, we have two products, so we have to use the product rule for each of them. Taking the first one, we get x squared times the derivative of y, which is y prime. To that, we add the derivative of x squared, or 2x, times y. Now we do the other product. This will give us x times the derivative of y squared. And once again, anytime we take the derivative of the variable representing the function, and there are other operations on that variable, we must use the chain rule. So the derivative of y squared will be 2y times y prime. Again, this makes sense if we imagine y as being some function full of x's. If that were inside parentheses and then squared, we already knew from learning the chain rule that the derivative of this would be 2 times what's inside the parentheses times the derivative of what's inside the parentheses. That's what we are doing here, just with y representing whatever might be in there. And then to finish the product rule, we get the derivative of x, which is 1, times y squared. On the other side, 3x becomes 3. Once again, let's keep any terms with y prime on this side and bring the other terms to the other side so that we can factor a y prime out of this sum. Once we have done that, we can then divide both sides by this whole parenthetical term, which allows us to solve for y prime. That gives us 3 minus 2xy minus y squared all over x squared plus 2xy. Let's do just one more that looks a little different. How about 4 cosine x sine y equals 1? Well, first let's divide both sides by 4. That will make things a little easier, since 1/4 will become 0 anyway, and then we don't have to deal with the 4. Now, for the left side, we have a product, so let's use the product rule. That gives us cosine x times the derivative of sine y plus the derivative of cosine x times sine y. Now for the derivatives, the derivative of sine y will require the chain rule. The derivative of the outer function, sine, is cosine, so we get cosine y, but then we multiply by the derivative of the inner function, y, which is y prime. Then for the other derivative, cosine x will become negative sine x. Now we simply bring negative sine x sine y to the other side, divide by cosine x cosine y, and we have solved for y prime. Just one last step. We know that sine over cosine is tangent, So sine x over cosine x becomes tangent x, and sine y over cosine y becomes tangent y. So y prime equals tangent x tangent y. So that's all there is to it. Implicit differentiation seems tricky at first, but once you get the algorithm down, it's no sweat, as we are just applying things that we already know, like the product rule and chain rule. The only trick is to remember that if solving for y prime, it means that y is some function in terms of x, and anytime we take the derivative of y, if there are other things operating on y, we will have to use the chain rule, which will produce the y prime terms that we end up solving for. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.